Assalamu alaikum. Welcome back. You're watching Towards the Origin in conversation with Sheikh Qadi Lutfur Rahman, the respected Imam and Khatib, one of the Imam and Khatib of the famously known mosque, Regent's Park Mosque in central London. Inshallah, tonight's topic for discussion is the roles and responsibility of husband and wife. In our first segment, we have touched upon and discussed about the importance of marriage, the importance of respecting each other, the love, the compassion, and most importantly, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he ensured by ensuring giving rights to others before he even thought about ourselves. And all of this and many more, inshallah, we'll be continuing in this segment, particularly about the roles and responsibilities of the husband and the wife accordingly, inshallah. Thank you very much to all of those who have joined us through our Facebook Live page, and this program you'll be able to watch the repeat the following day, and inshallah later on you'll also find us on our YouTube channel. In the meanwhile, if you have any suggestions, any questions and concerns, please do feel free to email us, and the email is displayed at the bottom of the TV screen, but for your reference it's towardstheorigin@chsuk.tv. Now, in the first segment we just ended on the aspect of the relationship, about the importance of the husband and wife, about the importance of the nikah contract. Now, in this segment, I would like to start with first, as a husband, what is the first and the foremost, the important responsibility should he be aware of even before he gets into the contract of a nikah?
Okay, bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. So first of all, one of the roles of a husband is that he must understand the concept of justice, meaning like he must be fair. He must establish the fairness and justice, al-adl, wal-insaf, amongst his family members. So now, if he has, first of all, more than one wife, then he must be equal in terms of giving the rights or in terms of like serving the both or you know, the wives that he has. If he has only one wife, then he has to balance it between the wife and mother. For example, like, you know, you live in a family, of course you've got wife, you've got mother, you've got sisters. Now, many of us, we become biased. If not all, but many, we become biased. Some of us, we go towards the wife, and some of us, we go towards the
mother
or the sisters, or maybe other family members. And now, we have to be very careful here. The concept of fairness is really important in Islam. We must have insaf. If we don't establish insaf, then this have a big consequences. So therefore, I think one of the first things that our scholars, they have discussed and they've mentioned, a husband must be adil and munsif. That he must establish and he must make sure that there are some sort of balance and fairness amongst the family members, especially if the wife is living with in-laws.
In-laws. Now, here there's another issue here. If the house is generally a standard three-bedroom house, say for instance, a three-bedroom house with one shower room or toilet in there, and then you already have siblings living there, would it not be difficult for a wife to adjust in such kind of situation?
Yes, it can be difficult, but then again, it varies from family to family, people to people. So I can't give actually like a full absolute judgment on that. It varies from people to people.
So then,
for some people, it can be very difficult, yes, but for others, it could be okay.
Especially for those sisters who wants to practice religiously and spiritually their hijab,
yes,
or perhaps even from the husband's brother and so on. Now, in a small house with an extended family, it becomes a challenge. Yeah, so when the question of fairness comes in, then it's slightly challenging there.
It could be difficult, but then, as I said, circumstances of the people are different, and I can't give an absolute judgment on or generalize the whole entire issue. But yes.
Alternative option can be looked into?
Alternative options can be looked into, definitely, for sure. অর্থাৎ আমাদের আমরা যারা আছি হাজব্যান্ড যারা স্বামী আছি আমাদেরকে কিন্তু ইনসাফ আমাদেরকে রাখতে হবে আমাদের সামনে আমরা শুধু নামাজ এবং রোজা এবং হজ জাকাত করলে হবে না ওইগুলোর থেকে আমরা অবশ্যই আমরা সওয়াব এবং হাসিল করি অর্জন করি কিন্তু অন্য অন্য দিক আছে ইসলামের যেগুলো দেখে আমরা সিরিয়াসলি দেখতে হবে এবং এর মধ্যে একটা হচ্ছে ইনসাফ এবং এই ইনসাফটা কিন্তু আমাদেরকে বিশেষ করে আমাদের মা এবং আমাদের ওয়াইফ এর মধ্যখানে আমাদেরকে মুনসিফ হতে হবে আই নো ইটস এ ভেরি ডিফিকাল্ট চ্যালেঞ্জিং টাস্ক ইটস নট ইজি ফর অ্যাকচুয়ালি এ ম্যান ফর এ হাজব্যান্ড বাট উই ট্রাই আওয়ার বেস্ট আমাদেরকে আমাদের সর্বোচ্চ আমাদেরকে চেষ্টা করতে হবে এবং সব থেকে আমাদের আপ্রাণ চেষ্টা করতে হবে এই ইনসাফকে
এখানে একটা জিনিস ক্লিয়ার করা দরকার আছে দ্যাট ইন নো ওয়ে শুড আ মাদার্স রাইট or the wife's right should anyway be fallen short.
Exactly.
It's the responsibility violated.
Yes.
So it's the responsibility of the husband to ensure both the rights are given its due status and respect.
Yes,
is that correct?
Yes, yes. And I think also in order to support a man, wives and mothers should be also helpful.
Fair enough.
And unless they become helpful, this man
so
will
be... So it's a two-way street rather than a one-way.
...will be in a huge difficulty. So mothers should consider the son, that son has wife now, and also wife should understand that the son has, the husband has mother, and he can't leave the parents, like, you know, and he's responsible towards his parents.
Now, there's a cultural element to it. Now, the mom would think that I've fed and I've, you know, this son has been with me for the last 25, 28, 30
exactly.
years, and all of a sudden he's got married.
Yes.
Now he's completely detached from me. That's feeling. And then the wife still may think, perhaps, for example, the son is my husband is like a mother's
yes,
child.
I think there's
still.
Also a very lot of influence, like, you know, this you know, people want to influence. So I mean, husband become a subject of influence. So mothers want to influence the son, and the wives want to also influence the husband. So I think we need to be fair, and we need to understand that this boy or this son was actually taken care and brought up by these parents, and he has huge responsibilities towards them. So wives should be understanding, as well as mothers should be understanding, because that girl or that wife, that woman, she left one family and joined another family. She migrated from one family to join another family, and that's a big sacrifice, and that must be also appreciated. So this is number one, insaf and adl. Number two is, of course, a role, or second most important role of a husband in Islam, or from the Islamic perspective, is the financial maintenance. Of course, that's after giving the mahar, dowry. And mahar is, of course, something that is given in appreciation to our wives in order to appreciate their sacrifice of leaving one family and joining another family. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَآتُ النِّسَاءَ صَدُقَاتِهِنَّ نِحْلًا. Give something to your wives in a cheerful manner. অর্থাৎ তোমরা মানে যতটুকু তোমাদের সম্ভব, তোমাদের তাকতের ভিতরে যতটুকু আছে, ক্যাপাসিটির ভিতরে, তোমাদের ওয়াইফকে তোমরা কিছু কৃতজ্ঞতা প্রকাশ করার জন্য কিছু তোমাদের ওয়াইফকে দাও.
Now there, this is where the problem comes in now. I'll have to address the real issues. I'm sure as imam, and a lot of case studies that we have seen in our community that takes place. For example, the groom perhaps could be a chauffeur, or perhaps working in a skilled working environment, or works in a graduate position. So obviously he finished his education, got into the professional life, so he hasn't reached the pinnacle of his position that he's in now.
Yeah.
And then you see marriage takes place, because our parents, alhamdulillah, the community that we come from, always, as soon as you're graduated and you're going to job,
our
parents have that responsibility in their head to, inshallah, make sure that the respective children get married. Now, this is where the problem starts. You get the mahar double the size or the amount than the boy earns.
Exactly. Yeah.
Number one. And then there's two type of mahar. If the boy is from this country, has got an original British passport, you will see there's a difference to the mahar when the groom does not have a British nationality.
Again,
now you see there's a two types of mahar there.
Yes.
Now the element of dhulm I wanted to bring in here. Now as an imam, I'm sure you have seen this. How would we, as father of a daughter, should take into perspective? Because at the end of the day, it's my daughter that's going to get married off to this son-in-law.
I mean, again, like, the concept of mahar must not be commercialized. But the doctor,
$20,000, $25,000.
Exactly. So it must not be a case that we're earning, actually, through this. No, it's given to our wives, to our sisters, as an appreciation. And something that a husband, it should be made easy, and it should be, again, with the concept of ihsan. With the concept of ihsan. Ihsaner concept onujayi amaderke ei mohor ke amra kintu deal korte hobe amader jonno. To ei jonno I think, again, like, as you mentioned, like, we must be again fair, and we must not make things difficult, especially if somebody doesn't have a British passport.
These are things we looked into. But however, the problem that I see is a daughter's father demanding that has to be 25k, 30k, when the boy himself doesn't even earn 30k.
I mean, that's something like we need to really look into our society. And as I said, mahar cannot be commercialized. Eta byabsha banijjo pornito hote parbe na. Eta ekta dini byapar, ebong eta dini byapar is a religious matter which need to be kept according to the parameter.
And just in just a minute, if you can touch, how should one fix the amount of mahar? Is it depending on the income that a boy?
Yes,
I mean, putting into perspective,
yes,
as we use the word fairness?
Everybody, I think everyone's according to their financial capacity. If someone's earning like say millions of pounds, then he should give according to his capacity. If someone's earning say 20K a year, then again, that's according to, if someone's 10K a year, then again, according to his
capacity.
And it has to be according to the level and standard of financial capacity of a person.
Within the means.
Within the means, exactly. Okay. And that's how we should fix this, inshallah. So we're talking about here again, after mahar, the nafaqah. So role of a husband is to provide the nafaqah. What's nafaqah? Nafaqah, يعني وقد أجمع علماء الإسلام على وجوب نفقات الزوجات. That the scholars of Islam unanimously agreed that the nafaqah must be given to the wives. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Noble Quran, لينفق ذو ساعة من ساعتي. That if a person can afford, then he should give according to his level and standard. You see, again in the Quran it says, لينفق ذو ساعة من ساعتي. Allah কাকে যদি দন সম্পদ দিয়ে থাকেন তাহলে সে সেই দন সম্পদ অনুযায়ী সে এটা ব্যয় করবে
না এখানে একটা প্রশ্ন আছে আমার দন সম্পদ কিসের উপরে বাবার দন সম্পত্তি আছে ছেলে ওই সূত্রে কিন্তু দেখা গেলে ধন সম্পত্তি ও অ্যাসেট আছে বাট ইফ ইউ বেস অন দ্য চাইল্ড অর দ্য সান ইটসেলফ সে হয়তো গ্র্যাজুয়েট পজিশনে আছে 25-30K হনো তার স্যালারি আছে বাট ইফ ইউ লুক এট হিজ ফ্যামিলি ব্যাকগ্রাউন্ড হিজ ফাদার কুড বি আ মিলিয়নার নাও হাউ ডু ইউ সেট আপ
দ্যাট अगेन इट्स अ রেসপন্সিবিলিটি অফ দ্য সান অফ দ্য হাজবেন্ড নট লাইক প্যারেন্টস এন্ড আদার্স আই মিন আনলেস দ্য আদার্স আর গিভিং
willingly
deliberately, yeah, with their choice. And that's a different thing. But you know, someone must not be dependent as well. Again, this is not right in Islam to be dependent on others.
কারণ আমাদের এখানে ধারণা হচ্ছে না যে সে তো বংশ ধনী ঘরের ছেলে তো তা we can ask for
so we look at these kind of things but we must not rely on those others, okay. Other people. So anyway, so talking about nafaqa, so when we say nafaqa, that it should be given shami tar strike tar income তার উপার্জন অনুযায়ী সে তার ওয়াইফের উপর ব্যবহার মানে স্পেন্ড করবে ব্যয় করবে এবং এটার মধ্যে হচ্ছে অর্থাৎ এটার মধ্যে হচ্ছে আপনার অ্যাকোমোডেশন অর্থাৎ বাসার অ্যাকর্ডিং টু দ্য ক্যাপাসিটি অফ হাজব্যান্ড বাসা ও দ্য হাউস শুড বি প্রিপেয়ার্ড ফর ওয়াইফ তারপর হচ্ছে আপনার খানা দানা ফুড ড্রিঙ্কস
প্রোভিশন
ক্লোদিং কাপড় চোপড় যেটা আছে এটাও কিন্তু স্বামীর দায়িত্ব ওয়াইফকে দিবেন তারপরে যতটুকু মানে ফান্ডামেন্টাল নেসেসিটি যেগুলো আছে প্রাইমারি যে নেসেসিটিগুলো আছে এগুলো কিন্তু স্বামী স্ত্রীকে প্রোভাইড করবেন
আরেকটা জিনিস আমি ক্লারিফাই করতে চাই মেহরের কথা এই টাকাটা পায় কে বাবার অ্যাকাউন্টে যায় না মেয়ের অ্যাকাউন্টে যায়
এটা তো মেয়ের
বিকজ অনেক সময় উই হ্যাভ সিন দ্য ফাদার ইন ল
দে দ্য ওয়ান টেকিং
ইট এন্ড পুটিং ইট ইন দেয়ার অ্যাকাউন্ট রাদার দ্যান দ্য ডটার হ্যাভিং দ্য মানি ইন দেয়ার অ্যাকাউন্ট
এন্ড আনলেস লাইক again the daughter she gives because that's her asset that's her if she wants to give it to anybody then that's fine
freely and willingly without
yes,
any compulsion
that's right yeah, that's right so nafaqa is a responsibility but unfortunately many of the husbands today will rely on wives Okay. But Islamically, from the religious perspective, we as husband must be responsible. Whatever we can bring, whatever we income we have, we must provide. But many of us, we think we rely on, we even marry sometimes, like, you know, by looking at the financial status of the wives. You know, wife will bring money, wife will bring lots of furniture. You see, and
the cultural aspect.
আমরা এটাকে কি বলি যে এটাকে বাংলায় কি বলে যে ওয়াইফ উইল বি ব্রিংইং লট অফ স্টাফ ফার্নিচার এন্ড স্টাফ টু 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 হাজব্যান্ডস হোম হাউস হোল্ড নাও আগেইন ইসলাম ডাজন্ট রিয়েলি সে দ্যাট আনলেস ইউ নো দ্য পিপল ওয়ান্ট টু গিভ ইউ উইলিংলি আগেইন উইদাউট এনি ফোর্স দেন দ্যাটস ডিফারেন্ট লাইক
গিভ সমাজে একটা তো কম্পালশন হয়ে গেছে দ্যাট দ্য ওম্যান ইজ এক্সপেক্টেড টু ব্রিং দোজ
ইভেন উই হ্যাভ হ্যাড দ্য কেসেস লাইক দ্য ওম্যান ক্যান বি ডিভোর্সড ফর দ্যাট রিজন
And it happened in
our countries, unfortunately. But Islam doesn't put any kind of, Islam doesn't give any guideline on that. You know, that a wife must
But there's no obligation on the wife.
But however, if they bring this beautiful thing, it should be like a gift. It should be like presents, not like anything.
No, but then again, the problem is then it should not be treated as if there's a subliminal message or an indirect hint that this is what you should bring. But it looks like it's a gift, but there's an indirect hint.
There must not be any kind of hint or pressure or even indirect sort of like indications to say that, you know, why did you... Sometimes, আমাদের দেশে বলা হয় যে কোটা দেওয়া হয়। যে মনে করেন ওয়াইফ নিয়ে আসতে পারে নাই বা হয়তো কোনো কারণে বা পারিবারিক দরিদ্রতার কারণে হয়তো বাবা দিতে পারেন
ফাইন্যান্সিয়াল
কিন্তু যারা যে মাদার ইন ল এবং ফাদার ইন ল যারা আছেন অর্থাৎ মানে যে
শ্বশুর
শাশুড়ি যারা আছেন ওনারা কিন্তু এটাকে কুটা দেন বলেন যে তুমি তো কোনো কিছু নিয়ে আসো নাই ইউ হ্যাভন্ট ব্রট এনিথিং
বাট দেন অ্যাগেইন ইটস নট রাইট ভেরি ট্রু বাট দেন আর দি আদার সাইড অফ ইট আমরা এইরকম শুনেছি যে কিচ্ছু লাগবে না বাট এগুলো আনলে ভালো হবে
again yes so it's cultural thing and I think we must become we must grow like become big in our minds. জি এবং আমাদের মাইন্ড কে আমরা কিন্তু আরো বড় করতে হবে এবং আমরা অন্যের উপর ডিপেন্ড করতে পারবো না তারপর হচ্ছে নাফাকা নাফাকা হচ্ছে ফান্ডামেন্টাল নেসেসিটি এবং এটা কিন্তু কোন কোন স্কলাররা এটার সাথে কিন্তু চিকিৎসাও এড করেছেন or a chikitsa treatment medical aspect also should be covered by husband but there are some scholars who said that the husbands are not really responsible for the medical treatments but many scholars they have done
now this. Just to quickly touch on the other element as well ekhane onek amra jeto ei western society thaki onek shomoy ami dekhechi onek marriages takes place acha na hole to oshubidha nai the state will fund me the state will provide me home the state will provide me with benefit is that a good idea
yes again no again I think as Muslims
should we be burden on the state
no as Muslims again we must be always not depending we the concept of tawakkul like you know depending on others is disliked highly in Islam
okay.
that you know we just look at the hands of other people I mean this is charity and we must not like look at the hands of the charity we always rely on our own maqsab our means own maqsab and that's how Islam teaches us and that's how we're supposed to be so this is nafaqa is a responsibility of husband towards his wife and it should be fulfilled now if a wife again on the other side if she wants to participate if she wants to take part then that's also fine and Islam doesn't like condemn or Islam doesn't say like you know that
put a restriction
yeah, right. restriction on that mutual agreements are respected by Islam as Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said al-muslimuna inda shurutihim any mutual agreements are respected So then I think another and probably this could be the last because I'm sure there are many roles of husband and wife in Islam but as for the role of a husband again or responsibility of a husband towards his wife the last one here for today is husnul muashara well treatment generally
in society
in society meaning that we be kind merciful tolerant and you know compassionate towards our wives and the prophet muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam he made a very important inspiring speeches known as the speech of hajjatul wida or that bidai hajjar bashan rasul karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam kintu khub guruttopurno ekta bashan ei bashaner part ebong ongsho chilo rasul karim sambolen je istausu bin nisa'i khaira or tumra tumader mohilader proti tumra bhalo byabohar koro shot byabohar koro tumra tader proti doya ebong mercy ebong kindness ke tumra obolombon koro
and it's very true amra jodi dekhi bortoman science er aloke jodi dekhi আমরা মেয়েরা কিন্তু বা ওমেন দে আন্ডারগো লট অফ চেঞ্জেস পারহ্যাপস
এভরি মান্থ
দ্য ফিজিওলজিক্যাল চেঞ্জ দ্য বায়োলজিক্যাল চেঞ্জ ফিজিক্যাল চেঞ্জেস
ইয়েস ইয়েস ইয়েস
যার জন্য এখানে আমাদেরকে অ্যাজ আ ম্যান উই শুড অলসো বি আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ডিং টুয়ার্ডস দোজ চেঞ্জেস এন্ড পারহ্যাপস উই শুড অলসো কনসিডার
Yes.
মানে কিছু বলার আগে যে what sort of situation are we in
yes, exactly so we must be kind and merciful and generally tolerant towards our women which is an important role of a husband
now eagerly we've been waiting now the roles and responsibility that we
yeah.
strive to find out or we have happened to hear a lot is about what's the role and responsibility of
a
woman or a wife yes. in the marriage
yes so now for example now I was really interested I mean I really see that nowadays a lot of people they only talk about the roles of a husband but hardly talk about the roles of wives but also wives play a vital and important role in the marriage life and many people actually don't discuss about it and I think in the western world people hardly talk about the roles of wives whereas in the eastern world people hardly talk about the roles of husbands and so we as Muslim we have to be in the balance and in the middle so now first of all I see here that we must understand Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives status to everybody Allah gives status a daraja to women as mothers but to husband as men so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the noble Quran wal rijali alayhin daraja Allah gave the husband a status a daraja a rank
singular
and that need to be respected and honored now obviously as I said mothers are highly respected none of us can go to paradise if our mothers are unhappy and so husbands
we know the famous hadith of the rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam who deserves the most compassion to us
yes yes
and he said three times the mother and then the fourth time he said the father so in this angle the mother not only wins the gold silver and the bronze and the father just had to be satisfied with just to the fourth place if you see it from that perspective
so exactly so the rijali alayhin wal rijali alayhin daraja our wives should understand that the husbands have a status in Islam and they are also subject to of respect that they should be respected then we find again the role of a wife in the household of a husband is something that normally we forget and that is at-ta'ah so meaning like there should be some sort of like understanding and taking the the concerns of husbands into consideration. At-ta'ah is very, very important in Islam. And now, obviously, we see the financial maintenance was the responsibility of a husband, you see? But in exchange, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he gave the managership of the house to a husband. Now, I have not said the leaders. I didn't say the husband are leaders, because leaders can be dictators, and Islam doesn't support the dictatorship. Allah Pak Rabbul Alameen, Quran Al-Kamim Maddu Balachan, Ekta Ayat Al-Muddi, Ar-Rijalu Qawwamun Ala Nisa. Now many people misinterpret that verse. One ek again to a ayat al-Opubakka Kore Taken. Ar-Rijalu Qawwamun Ala Nisa. The men are stronger, men are leaders, men are this. And then they misinterpret the verse. But the actual meaning and the explanation of the verse, the Ar-Rijalu Qawwamun Ala Nisa, that the Rijal, the man, should be responsible. First of all, and through responsibility, they attain the managership. So the managership of the household is given to a husband. Now, we understand the importance of managership in everything. Or that manager, the guru, amra shob jagay buji, kajer modde, businesser modde, companyer modde. But when it comes to a family, we tend to not give the importance to the managership.
Karan hotse, we do not consider the family as an institution.
Exactly, yes.
Karan kono ekti institution, you will always have a managerial role or role of authority. Yes. Whereas amra family ke ekta institution hisabe dekhi na. We merely see my right and your right. This is what I should do, this is what you should do.
Yes.
Is it not the problem lying there?
Yes, exactly. So the one of the most important institutions in society is families. If the families are stable, then the society is stable, the country is stable. If the families are unstable, then society is unstable. And so therefore, we have to understand the importance of managership in family. And managers mean husband, sit, consult, discuss, and make the best decisions for the family. Now, we see this fight over this managership. Now, some of us, we say, now, I don't want to accept this, like, you know. Again, when it comes to the right, then we fully seek the rights. You know, you are responsible to give, you're responsible to, you know, provide and all of those things. When it comes to the other way around, then we say, no, you know, we can't do that. This is not the time. The time has changed. We bring a lot of excuses to avoid the roles or avoid the responsibility.
Now, I see that as a sales pitch. When we are trying to sell a product in the professional world, it's all about presentation.
Yes.
It's all about how you put your points across. Similarly, in a marriage, আপনি যখন বলেছেন কনসালটেশনের কথা ওয়াশাওয়ার হোম ফিল আমর তো এখানে যখন আমরা কনসালটেশন করব দি প্রেজেন্টেশন শুড অলসো বি ইন আ নাইস ইন আ ভেরি আর্টিকুলেটেড এন্ড আ রেসপেক্টেড ম্যানার
অফ কোর্স
মানে আমাদের সময় একটা সমস্যা দেখা যাচ্ছে যখন আমরা প্রেজেন্ট করি বা একটা জিনিস উপস্থাপন করি একটা পয়েন্ট অ্যাজ ইফ লাইক আই এম ডিকটেটিং ইট রাদার দেন দিস ইজ হোয়াট আই এম থিংকিং হোয়াট উড ইওর থট
বি এগেইন লাইক শুরা এগেইন শুরা কনসেপ্ট ইন ইসলাম মাস্ট বি রেসপেক্টেড এন্ড ইভেন হাজবেন্ড এন্ড ওয়াইফ দে শুড বি শুরা বাট দেন ওয়েন ইট কামস টু ওয়েন দ্য ডিসপিউট টেক প্লেস দেন দ্যাট to be a final decision and final say, and that's something that we need to look into. And unless we have this understanding, then we'll have problems always occurring in our families.
And that's the reason why the Quran clearly speaks about it. If there is any dispute, revert back to the Quran and Sunnah.
Yes.
Isn't that true?
Yes, that's right. So again, so wujub al-ta'ah and also like adhering to the concerns of the husband and also managership of the household is husband is important, a role of a wife.
Yep. And the other thing I just wanted to, because time is running out, I'm very short of time. The other problem we do notice, even I've noticed in professional workplaces, that sometimes we do see men, it's very rarely found. However, we see women talking about the bedroom issue with their female colleagues.
Yeah, and that's wrong.
And again, that's in a public place.
Yes. Again, this is something really important. Confidentiality must be maintained and it must not go outside. And that's, again, it's highly, you know, respect, and Islam give a lot of importance to this confidentiality or privacy issue. Okay, now coming to, again, more roles of a wife. Now, of course, like we always say, that husbands are Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala distribute. Sometimes we misunderstand the modern people in modern society, they misunderstand that, you know, they say that the husband's oppressing the wives. You know, there's a lot of misconception, but they don't understand really Islam distributed the roles, the work to make things better. So, now, the role of a wife also, tamkeen az-zawj min al-istimta'. So a wife should make herself available for the relationship with her husband to maintain the husband-wife relationship. And that's, again, in exchange of his provision.
And so as the husband should also have an understanding of that, course. Mutual understanding.
And also, the last thing that I want to mention, that many times we hear, do we have any time?
Yeah, it's just last 10 seconds.
Okay, so many times we also hear from our wives that wives don't have to work at home. Like we really hear, আমাদের অনেকে বলে যে ওয়াইফরা কিন্তু বাসায় মানে স্বামীর খেদমত করতে হবে না বা দে ডোন্ট হ্যাভ টু ওয়ার্ক এট হোম That's not actually right. Many, many scholars, they said it's very important, and some of them it's mandatory to work and do the responsibilities at home within the household of the husband. It's mandatory according to many scholars, but some scholars say it's very important, but not mandatory. But some scholars, they do see it as a wajib to work in the house of husband.
Jazakallah khair. I would have loved to continue the discussion, but I'm sure really our time is up. And thank you very much for joining with us so late at night.
No problem, inshallah. You're welcome.
With this, my dear viewers, we've come to the conclusion of our tonight's program and discussion. What we have learned is that roles and responsibility of husband and wife are unique in itself. However, to maintain a sacred relationship, we have to always ensure that we suggest, we discuss, and perhaps present ideas and thoughts in a manner that is acceptable. And also, we have to look into a time frame when these things are discussed. And last point, we are going to the Hajj, and especially to those brothers and sisters who are going to Hajj. Let us make sure that we promise to ourselves that when we return, we should see a change within ourselves. Inshallah, until we meet next time, subhanakallahumma hamdik nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Jazakallah khair, Sheikh. Thank you very much.